Can I start by asking you a little bit about Titanic, obviously a film that you've just signed a poster for and still means so much to so many people. What does that particular piece of work and memories of it mean to you?
Well, I mean, it was not an easy film to make, but I got on. I hear lots of rumours about, or people say, how do I get on with James Cameron? Because he seems to have a reputation for various things. I got on with him very well. And I really love working with Leonardo. It was great fun, and Kate, of course. You never know when you're making a film how it's going to turn out, but it did seem to deliver the goods to the public, and it did what it set out to do. So it was great to be part of it, very lucky to be part of it.
Lovely to hear that you had such a great time with Leo and Kate. Can you talk about what makes them both such special performers and why you enjoyed your time with them so very much?
Well, I spent time with them on the set, not particularly socially. Well, Leonardo, because I think he's a wonderful actor. I saw him in Gilbert Grape, and I didn't know they'd hired an actor. I'd never heard of him before. And he was lovely because I said to him, about Romeo and Juliet, because I've done a bit of Shakespeare, so I thought I'd just mention that. And I said, I really liked him as Romeo. And he looked at me and he said, wasn't Claire Danes good? And I thought, this is a good guy, a wonderful actor and a good guy. Kate was just fun. You know, I didn't spend much time with her, but she was lovely. And it was, as I say, it was a difficult film to make. And just having smashing people around really made it, really pleasurable.
You've already mentioned Jim. He has such a big reputation. How much of that is deserved and how much of it is myth and legend?
Well, I mean, he's one of those, he's a perfectionist. So if people don't sort of do what he wants, he tends to raise his voice, shall I put it that way. Fortunately, he didn't raise his voice to me.
You are involved in one of our favourite Christmas films of all time. Can you talk a little bit about what it was like to work on that classic retelling of such an iconic and beautiful story?
What are you talking about? Christmas Carol?
Christmas Carol, yeah.
Actually, they asked me to play Marley's ghost. And I thought, no, it's lovely to work with George C. Scott, but I really wanted to play Bob Cratchit. And I asked and sort of lobbied on my own behalf with my agent, I got to play Bob Cratchit, and it was a delightful experience, especially as people say here at Showmasters or whatever, say, you know, you only play villains. So it was great to play Bob Cratchit with the great George C. Scott. To spend time with him was just wonderful.
You have a most special memory of your time with George.
We played Trivial Pursuit in his trailer. And as you know, he played Patton. And there were a lot of questions about Patton in Trivial Pursuit. And he was so angry because he said they got them all the answers were wrong. But apart from that, he was just, a wonderful... He had such a kind of reputation of being a giant. So I was quite kind of scared when I first met him, but he put me at ease and we had a lovely time. He was lovely.
You obviously mentioned you're very well known for playing villains, particularly in Tron, which is a beloved sci-fi classic. Can you talk a little bit about your memories of making that iconic and groundbreaking piece of cinema?
I didn't understand a word I was talking about. I had no idea what I was talking about. And, it wasn't really acting, but it was... we didn't know, of course, it was going to turn out to be what it turned out to be, a very special piece of cinema. But... as I say, I was very confused. I don't know anything about computers. I still don't. And it was the very beginning of all that and before CGI. So it was just a very interesting acting challenge, although it didn't involve acting. It's hard to explain, and I won't go on about it. But it's great to be part of something that's become such a thing, I suppose.
Talking about unique, you were obviously part of Time Bandits working with one of the most eccentric and wonderful filmmakers in Terry. Can you talk a little bit about that character and why he remains so beloved and iconic?
Well, I mean, he puts his dreams on, I would say, celluloid, because now, of course, it's video. You feel he has a dream and is able to get it up there on the screen, which is fantastic. I was glad to be in Time Bandits because Jonathan Pryce wasn't available, so I got the part. and he was delightful. It was a tough film, physically, but not because of Terry. Terry was a delight, and everybody was a delight. But physically, it wasn't easy, but it turned out to be what it is. And I'm delighted, again, to be part of something like that.
Been a part of Star Trek on many different occasions. What does it mean for you to have that ongoing relationship with this franchise?
Well, I mean, my relationship stopped quite a while ago, but I mean, I played three different species, you know, human and Cardassian and Klingon, and I don't know, it was, to be asked back was quite... I didn't quite know why they asked me back, especially in Star Trek V, I played a human being. Then they asked, then Nick Meyer, who I'd worked with before, on Time After Time, another classic, if you know that picture. Somehow I ended up doing it. So, yeah, it's great to be part of that franchise.
We've talked about many of the different wonderful projects you've been involved in. I'm curious, is there one that you are personally most proud of, that is most special to you, that the one that you hope they remember you for?
No, that's a very difficult question. The Peckinpah, a couple of Peckinpah pictures, Ballad of Cable Ho. Whether I want to be remembered for it, I don't know, but they're something very special. To make three films for Sam Peckinpah was something very, very special. Working with Gregory Peck on The Omen was really special. Working with giants like James Mason in a couple of films is very special. I don't know how many of you people watching this have seen the films, but those for me are the memories. It's not so much of how I want to be remembered, but what marvelous moments I had in my life being with these people.